students, we will continue our previous topic, mathematical logic. See page number 7, sub question number 4.
In question 4, what you have given? You have given that statement P is true. Q is also true. And also you have given that statement R and S are false. Now we have to determine the truth value of the given statement. Statement is P conditional Q or R conditional S. First of all, substitute the values of P, Q, R, S. P is true, conditional Q is also true, or R is false, conditional S is also false. These are given. P and Q are true, R and S are the false statements. We have to determine the truth value of the given statement pattern. Now, P conditional T. What is the required condition for the connective if then conditional? For conditional, if first one is true, second one is false, then it is false. First true, second false, then it is false. And all the remaining cases, it is true. Here, both are true, therefore, this is false. This is true, sorry. Or, F conditional F, connective is same, if then, if first true, second false, then it is false, otherwise true, therefore this is also true. True or true, for the second connective or, what is the requirement? If both the statements are false, then their disjunction is false. And all the remaining cases, it is true. Here, both are true. Therefore, the given statement is true. Truth value is T. Okay, now the second one. Determine the truth value of the given statement. Condition is same. P and Q are true. R and S are false statements. And we have to determine the truth value of the given statement. Now, first of all, substitute the values of P, Q, R, S. Negation P, P is true. And negation Q is also true. And R is false. Or Q is true and R is false, or P is true and R is false. First of all, the brackets is equal to negation true. Negation true is false and negation false is true. So here is negation true, so write down false, and negation true, that is false, and false, F and F, or T. Now T and F, here is the connective and. What is the requirement for the connective and? For and, requirement is both are true, then it is true, otherwise it is false. Here, P and F, first true, second false. Therefore, this condition is not satisfied. Therefore, this is false. Write down F. Or, here, same connective and is there. Therefore, first true, second false. For the connective and, both the statements are true. Then the conjunction is true, otherwise false. Therefore, this is false. Now is equal to F and now here is also same connective and requirement is both are true, then it is true, otherwise false. Here both are false, therefore it is false, or false or false. For the second connective or requirement is both are false, then it is false. And all the remaining cases, it is Here both are false, therefore it is false. This is equal to same connective here and requirement for the connective and both are true, then it is true, otherwise false. Here both are not true, therefore it is false or false. For the second connective are both are false, then their disjunction is false, therefore it is false. Hence, true clarity is false. Okay, in the fifth question, in the same exercise, write down the negation of the following statements. First statement is Tirupati is in Andhra Pradesh. We have to write the negation of this statement. We can write in three different ways the negation of this statement. First one is, it is not true that Tirupati is in Andhra Pradesh. In another way also we can write, it is false that Tirupati is in Andhra Pradesh. Also we can simply negative statement, Tirupati is not in Andhra Pradesh. So its negation is negation statement. Tirupati is not in Andhra Pradesh. Now the second, here also we have to write the negation of this statement. Statement is 3 is not the root of the equation x square plus 3x minus 18 equal to 0. Now the given statement is already negative. So simply we write the negation, write down the statement positive, 3 is the root of the equation x square plus 3x minus 18 equal to 0. Alternatively we can write down the symbolic form and then write down its negation. Suppose the statement is 3 is the root of the equation x square plus 3x minus 18 equal to 0. Then negation 2 will become 3 is not the root of the equation x square plus 3x minus 18 equal to 0. But here we have given that the negative statement, it means the symbolic form is negation p. Symbolic form is negation p. Therefore, negation of negation p is equal to p. Therefore, 3 is the root of the equation x square plus 3x minus 18 equal to 0. Remaining for your homework. See you. Thank you.